The GNU Debugger is a very powerful debugger commonly used for cybersecurity and reverse engineering. The GNU Debugger is extremely powerful mainly because it's command line based, meaning there is no graphical interface for it. This gives it the ability of being extremely lightweight and convenient for any environment. It's important you learn how to use this debugger because we will use it a lot because of how hard it is to get feedback from assembly. This will give you the ability of finding bugs in any binary file. Plus, you can use it in cybersecurity and reverse engineering later if you learned it. Another advantage of GDB is that it's extremely customizable since it supports add-ons. Let's say I have a program which I'm debugging, and I place a breakpoint with GDB on it. I want GDB to display all the registers automatically when it hits this breakpoint. I could do that by installing a plugin called PEDA, turning an output like this to this. It might look like too much text like this, but trust me that when you get used to it, it can become extremely useful and make your debugging much faster. You can install GDB on Ubuntu by typing apt install GDB. At the exception of Windows, on any other operating system, you should be able to install it by typing your package manager GDB. Now let's say I made a hello world in assembly, and I involuntarily put an instruction which will cause the program to crash without knowing it. I build and link my program like always, but then when I run it, it crashed. And let's pretend like this hello world is a big program, not just a single file with just a couple of lines of code. So what do I do? Well, I can obviously use GDB to debug it. The first thing I'm going to do is type GDB, the name of my program, in order to open it. Okay, now let's try to find our start function. To do so, we can use info functions to list all the existing functions in our program. In this case, we get nothing because we don't have any functions in this program. But what we can do is find the start address, and to do that, GDB has a keyword which is start I. Here it gave us the start address, where the program will start. We can copy this address and disassemble all the instructions in this function by using disass and then the address. Here we can see all our instructions, especially where it stopped, which is a jump to 0xFF. When we type C to continue, the program receives a segmentation fault because it executes the jump. Now let's try to put a breakpoint ourselves on the address where the jump is to make sure it is the problem. To do so, you type B for breakpoint, an asterisk, and then the address where you want to break. Now, in order to run the program again, we can type R, and then yes. And here we don't get a segmentation fault, but we will stop at our jump instruction. Now, in order to continue the execution, just type C, and then we get our segmentation fault. So it is the problem. Now, if you want to delete breakpoints, you can first use the info keyword and list all the breakpoints by doing info breakpoints. Then, as you can see, we have one with the num 1, and then you type del, the number of the breakpoint, which in this case is 1. Now the breakpoint is gone, we can try to rerun the program again, and we get the segmentation fault. Now let's try to patch the program. So we're going to quit vim the program, and here we can see our jump instruction. Let's remove it, write back, and then let's compile and, or in this case, assemble and link the program again and debug it. Now if we get the start address and then disassemble it, we should not see the jump instruction anymore. And as you can see, it's gone. Let's try to put a breakpoint after the move, just to see how we can list the registers when we hit a breakpoint. So let's place a breakpoint there, and then run the program. Now, as we hit the breakpoint, let's try to list the registers by doing info registers. As you can see, we move the value 0x4 in EAX, and as you can see here, EAX has the value 0x4. Now, if we continue the execution, we should get hello.asm and an exit which says execute normally because we did an interrupt to print and an interrupt to exit the program. That's pretty much all you need to know about GDB for now. This tutorial doesn't need to be that deep into GDB because as you'll play with it, you'll learn a lot more. This is just the basics of GDB. Alright, that's all for this video. I hope you liked it and I'll see you in the next one.